November 4th is going to be my first time on opening up for Estrella TV, and you know, very excited for an increase of fans to watch me on TV now. My last fight with Michael Gaxola, it was an exciting fight. I experienced my first cut in the first round. My cut man, Rudy Hernandez, was able to clean it up, and you know, we fought through the whole thing, and we came out with the win. Right now, we're fighting Francisco Dominguez, and also seems like a tough fighter, likes to go forward, but we're gonna do what we have to do. We've been training hard. For my training camp, you know, we went a little bit different route. This time, we brought in our cut man. His name's Rudy Hernandez, and he's gonna help us out, try and do it different. You know, we've been feeling great, and we're already feeling ready. I was just a little bad kid, and did bad in school, and you know, my dad, he used to box himself. He kind of wanted me to kind of get my butt whooped, and he made me spar, and I ended up doing good. I ended up liking it. I couldn't go unless I also did good in school. So, you know, my schoolwork started increasing better, and I kept wanting to go to the gym, and from then on, you know, I stayed training.
As our fighters are making their way to the ring, Pablo Rubio, the Shark, Whittier, California, where they say they're prettier. This guy's got a pretty style, Doug Fisher. He's 7-0, and he's made all his fights at the Belasco Theater, so he has a big crowd behind him. Over 50 tickets were sold, made a little extra money in his pocket. Remember those days, JoJo, when you had to sell tickets?
Yeah, I remember those days, man. You get a little come up, yeah. a couple $15 here and there, so yeah. Eventually it all accumulates.
Now that everybody's asking you for 18 tickets for a pay-per-view fight, how dare they? How dare they? Pablo Rubio, Francisco Dominguez coming up. Our ring announcer is the one and only Joe Martinez. And he has been cued.
En el peso super gallo. And here we go, ladies and gentlemen, six rounds of boxing, this in the super bantamweight division. Los tres jueces por este combate, the three judges scoring this bout at ringside, Carla Caiz, Pat Russell, and Fernando Villarreal. And with the bell rings, your referee in charge of the action, encargado de ring, el referee, Dr. Lou Moran. Presentado primero en la esquina azul, con los pantaloncillos verde con azul y un peso de 121 libras y medias. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. Wearing tonight green, trimmed in blue, he weighed officially 121.5 pounds. Un veterano de 15 peleas de la Ciudad Juárez, México, presentando Francisco Dominguez. Y sobre de la esquina roja, con los pantaloncillos camuflajes y un peso de 121 libras y medias. His opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner, wears black and gray camouflage and weighed in, also 121.5 pounds. In seven professional bouts, he stands perfect with seven victories and no defeats. The pride of Whittier, California, the undefeated Pablo the Shark Rubio Junior! Once again, your referee in charge, Dr. Lou Moretz.
Okay, Shark. Ven acá. Okay, ya les di las reglas. I give you instructions. Have a good clean fight. Bueno, pelea muy limpia. En la campaña. Wait for the gun.
Dr. Lou Moretz, bilingual, tail of the tape.
Rubio, at age 19, 11 years younger, he is 3 inches taller, and his reach is considerably longer.
That's why Doug Fisher does his homework. Write down your notes. As we are ready to go, six rounds in the super bantamweight division. Both these fighters weighing 121.6 at yesterday's weigh-in. Rubio, 19 years old, went to Whittier High School, home of the Cardinals. He's in the camouflage trunks. His opponent, Francisco Dominguez, 7-8, 30 years old from Ciudad Juarez, Mexico. Last time he was in the ring, he went against Nick Arce. They went the distance, a good scrap. And Doug's keys to victory for this fight. And Doug's keys to victory, I have a feeling, is don't wait.
Okay. This is for Dominguez. Don't wait. Just jump on him from the get-go. Try to draw him into a fight. Work the jab on the way in. And use some lateral movement, because guess what? Pablo Rubio Jr. is very comfortable in the trenches.
The taller fighter is Rubio. 7-0, 3 KOs. Trained by his dad, Pablo Sr. And the keys, more keys from Dougie.
These are Pablo Rubio Jr.'s keys to victory. Don't neglect that jab. He often does what he's doing right now. Gives up his height and reach. You want to use that at 5'9". He's very tall for a junior featherweight. And keep his composure. Don't get pulled into a needless slugfest.
Rubio 7-0. All of his fights have been here at the Belasco. Has over 100 people in attendance. Rubio, great sparring recently with Carl Frampton. They flew him to New York, spent a month with the Jackal as Jackal was getting ready for Leo Santa Cruz. Invaluable experience. Jojo, that just helps you, right? When you're the youngster and you go up against some of the bigger names?
Oh, yeah. Eventually, it all takes a toll, man. All that experience in sparring with road champions. The person that I was sparring with was Abner Martins and Leo Santa Cruz, and that gave me the experience to, you know, get ready for all my tough opponents that I was fighting. So this is definitely going to showcase, you know, what he was doing in sparring with Carl Frampton.
You know, when you go and do that sparring against these big-time guys, it's like might as well be a main event fight for you, right?
Oh, yes, absolutely. I mean, I bet you Rubio had the butterflies and everything going into the ring and sparring Carl Frampton, because he is a world-class fighter and he's a world champion and he has great skill. So, man, it's a great experience.
But when you come back and you're fighting a dude who's a journeyman, how do you stay mentally sharp like that too?
Well, you got to stay mentally sharp because you got to know that these guys are here to pull upsets, because, yeah, I mean, they don't have anything to lose. So they're just going to go out there and give it your all. So you can't just, you know, take this guy for granted and take this guy lightly, because this guy's game and he's going to want to, you know, pull the upset before he could get signed by Golden Boy Promotions.
Dominguez has taken some hard left hooks, but he's delivered some nice body shots in return.
Good opening round. It's scheduled for six between Rubio and Dominguez. Our opening bout at the Belasco Theater in downtown L.A.
Nice combinations from Rubio. Although he did catch a grazing right cross from Dominguez. Also the first round, engaging on the inside.
Nice and short, don't come up long. Nice and short, here, boom to the chest. Boom, boom. And then come across with the right hand. The right hands are coming in good. But you gotta be smart, don't throw it too far down. Look at him, all right? Good. Don't forget about the height. You can jab a little bit inside. You can jab a little bit instead of the punch.
Second round of action. Pablo Rubio, trained by his dad, Pablo Sr., a good fighter in his own day. Had a dad from South Central. Rubio in Whittier, California. Panchito Dominguez, Francisco. You know, Panchito's the nickname for Francisco. Ciudad Juarez on the border of El Paso. He is a police officer there in Juarez, and a fighter, police officer for 7 years. He actually took a 5-year break from boxing to focus on becoming a police officer there on the border town. Okay, he's back in it, got some seniority in the police department, which allows him a chance to make his own schedule. So he works 8 to 4, which means he's up at 5, running, getting his work in, goes to work, and then he does his conditioning and the sparring from 6 to 8 o'clock.
That tells you how much he loves boxing.
Yeah, I asked him, like, you know, your record isn't indicating. He's like, yeah. He goes, I just love it. He goes, I know they're giving me guys who I'm supposed to test. He goes, I know my role now as a veteran. But if I come in and I can beat some of these guys, they could easily flip. And he makes no bones about it. He's like, the money is good.
Yeah, you know what? He's going to the body really well against Rubio. Rubio, however, is outworking him on the inside and flashing some nice inside combinations. I like the left uppercut followed by the left hook that Rubio was landing earlier in the round.
Yeah, the similarities that Rubio has for me is he kind of fights like Leo Santa Cruz. He keeps a lot of pressure, throws a lot of shots, and has a high guard and digs to the body. And, man, he makes you not breathe. Whenever the guy tries to move around and create angles, Rubio's right back on him and being aggressive on the inside.
But Rubio likes to set the pace on his opponents.
Yeah, and I think that's one of the key factors to his game inside the ring is putting the pressure and making sure that he's the one that's dictating the pace.
I think as he progresses, he'll learn, as Leo Santa Cruz learned, to mix in some long-range boxing with the pressure and the inside fighting. Because one thing I've noticed in a lot of Rubio's fights is he comes away with a lot of blood. There's accidental clashes of heads that opens up cuts, and sometimes he's got a badly bloody nose.
Yeah, because Rubio, he likes to fight on the inside, and he likes to be aggressive all the time, but he's very tall for his weight, and he has a long reach, so, I mean, might as well use
that. Why not use it? Yeah.
Take advantage of that reach and height and fight on the outside and, set up the shots where you could land the more effective shots and the unexpected shots on the inside.
And who knows, maybe he's got some decent power at the end of those straight lefts and straight rights.
Exactly, yeah, because he's going to be able to turn shots a little more.
Rubio in the camouflage, 10 seconds to go in the second round. It's scheduled for 6. Odell Palacio Theater in downtown Los Angeles. And who is the shark? Pablo Rubio Jr. Here's more for the Spider Bio.
At age 19, he's still a teenager. 7-0, all here at the Blasco Theater. He's a LA Fight Club product. He's coming along very nicely.
Main event.
This has got to be a big deal. This has got to be a big deal for a teenager to be in the opening televised bout.
Yeah, his first time on the opening bout. He's used to opening the show at 5:30. It's a little different when you come at 7, and the vibe is a little bit different. There you see Pablo Sr. Here we go, third round, ready to go. The Shark nickname actually came from his dad's old trainer, the late Hector Shark. And for his dad to honor his late trainer, nicknamed his son the Shark. And now there's a company called Shark Sports, and the ring they're fighting in, Pablo knows it very well because the company that they own builds the rings for fights around Southern California. So when you say he knows his ring inside and out, yes, he does. He knows how to put it together.
He's putting some nice body shots together against Dominguez. He has to, because that's Dominguez's best punches to Rubio, hook to the body.
Another clash of heads. Dominguez doesn't have that chiseled physique, but he's rugged and he's tough and he's gonna be there. As our colleague Steve Kim would say, tough as that $2 steak.
And offering professional resistance.
That's another one.
That's the K9 glossary right there.
And another good article by K9. Make sure you check out his work, Steve Kim at UCN Live. He tweets every now and then.
Just a little bit.
Third round body work from Rubio. Going upstairs again. Starting to see the evolution of Pablo Rubio. 19 years old, still green, Doug. Remember the first time we saw him just 1,000 miles an hour throwing it as many punches as he could?
Yeah, he wasn't thinking at all. It was just pure work, just sheer conditioning and nerves, a lot of nerves in that pro debut. I'm sure he was feeling it at the end of the fight, round 4. But he's pacing himself. I mean, for him, he's pacing himself a little bit better. I've noticed the leverage at the end of his punches is better, and his punching technique is sharper.
Yeah, this round we've seen body work, seen uppercuts, going upstairs with the hooks. How long does it take, JoJo, for you to figure out, things are starting to slow down in the ring a little bit?
It took me probably my 10th or 11th fight.
Really?
My 10th or 11th fight because, you get fighting more tougher opponents, and you got to know that you got to dictate your own pace, and you got to, Xavier, because you are going longer rounds and longer distances in every single fight, so you got to make sure that you're keeping your composure at all times.
What about when you're fighting a real grown man? Like, a dude in his 30s, he's got those man muscles.
Oh, yeah, when they have the grown man strength, man, you got to just realize that you have the better skill for them, and, I mean, you train very hard for your fight. Yeah, this guy has probably the upper hand because he's older and he has the man strength and he's a little stronger than you, but you got the better skill and you're going to pull out the victory.
10 seconds to go in the round. Here's our opening bout. Coming up next, it's Emilio Sanchez, and working our way towards the main event of Tino Avila. 22-year-old Emilio Sanchez. There you see him working the mitts. He's coming up next. San Fernando High School, where he went, working with his trainer, Edgar Jasso, former fighter in his own right, Estrellita, Dancing Machine, out at the Rock Gym in Carson, California. That's a good lather going on already. And he's coming up next, undefeated. Emilio Sanchez takes on Yul Olguin. 8 rounds in the Super Bantamweight division.
Nice left to the body, left to the rib cage, landed by Dominguez. Rubio comes right back with his punches. Doesn't land them all, but constantly outworking the older man.
Beto Duran, Doug Fisher, undefeated Joseph Diaz Jr. Also with the microphone tonight, Abe Lopez, the Chamaco, and Thalia. So we got a full staff for tonight, so there's nothing that's going to left unturned, led by the one and only Will Wright. Man of many hats, executive vice president David Tatro, Golden Boy Media and Entertainment. Make sure you keep those tweets coming. Go check out the Golden Boy Instagram, where we took ourselves in the ring before that. Also check out the Golden Boy Snapchat. Everything possible. And if you want to check out the replays, the Golden Boy YouTube page. Doug's interviews from fighter workouts, they're all up there. And I think that body shot.
Yeah, Dominguez is feeling something. Yeah. He's either feeling the pace of this fight, or some of these body shots that Rubio has landed are beginning to take effect. And it's got to be discouraging because he's landed some choice lefts to the body of Rubio, and Rubio's as strong as ever and still coming at him.
Overhand right landed by Rubio, Abe Lopez. You know, Rubio, actually, want to get with you, Abe, in a bit.
Wow.
As Rubio's starting to jump on a bit.
Yeah, Rubio is using that body perfectly, but he needs to keep his distance because, I mean, he has longer arms, so wearing him down and then work the body as he's doing it as an inside, but keep the fight from outside.
You know him, don't you?
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Known him for quite a while already.
Have you sparred him before?
No, I have never had the chance to spar him, but you know, I mean, maybe one day, I mean, he can help me out or I can help him out too.
Abe Lopez checking with us throughout the rest of the night. Body work by Rubio here. And here you're starting to see the youngster with the conditioning, keeping in, a guy who is dedicated to boxing 100%, JoJo, unlike Dominguez, who, family man, has to take care of the kids, has to go to work, has to find a way to get to work, and you're starting to see him wear down here in the fourth round.
Yeah, and I bet it's difficult for Dominguez as well, because he does have a family and he does have a day job, and especially getting time to go inside the gym and put in those hours and running. It all takes a toll, man. It gets you tired, and you need your proper rest, too, because boxing is a brutal sport, so you need to get as much recovery as possible. And it's showing here today with Rubio, dictating the pace, putting a lot of pressure and getting him tired. And I truly believe that Dominguez has never been in this state of mind before. Rubio is constantly putting pressure on him, making him tired and vulnerable.
Heavy breathing from Dominguez in the blue and green. Pablo Rubio controlling this fight, looking good as a 19-year-old from Whittier. 10 seconds to go in the fourth round. It's scheduled for 6 in the Super Bantamweight division, and sold out in steamy Velasco Theater in downtown Los Angeles. Pablo Rubio has interest outside of the ring. He's into restoring antique cars.
besides boxing, my
other hobby is restoring muscle cars, you know. What got me also into it was the movie Fast and Furious. Wasn't into the whole foreign type of cars. I was more into Dominic Toretto's, the whole muscle cars. And, you know, I started viewing them online and, you know, I finally got my first car when I was 18. And from there, I've been buying and selling and, you know, making profits, you know, other ways to make money, but also enjoying what I'm doing. Right now, I have a 1967 Pontiac Firebird and I'm loving it.
How about that? Restoring a classic car. 19 years old. What did you have, Doug?
When I was 19, I had a 1980 Dodge Omni.
A 1972 Volkswagen Bug. JoJo, you got the Bentley or you got the Rolls?
Nah, I got the Mercedes right now, but...
right now.
Jeez.
Oh, that's right. You're pay-per-view. You can afford that. What was your first car, JoJo?
My first car was a 92 Honda Civic.
Okay, there you go.
I missed
go.
That baby, too, man.
There you go. Uh-huh. Your insurance does, too, doesn't it?
Exactly.
Fifth round of action. Joseph Diaz Jr. against Panchito Dominguez, the officer out of Ciudad Juarez, who actually brought his family with him for the first time to the United States. He's taking his two kids to Disneyland tomorrow. It's like, I already have my check spent. I got to take advantage of this. Because most of his fights have been in Mexico. He doesn't know, come back to the United States, so make it a vacation. But he's earning every single bit right now.
Yeah, he might get invited back. He's hanging tough. He's remaining game, even though visibly in round four, it looked like he was wearing down and maybe even starting to look for a soft spot on the canvas, as they used to say. Yep. But no, he's hanging in there.
Yeah, Dominguez is still a live dog. He's still throwing and retaliating and bouncing back after every shot. Rubio is being the aggressor. Right now, you can see that Rubio is trying to outbox him a little more and use his range.
But Dominguez is picking his spots, yeah.
Yeah.
If Rubio relaxes for just a second or admires his work, he can get caught.
Exactly. And he is throwing some sneaky body shots in there as well, Dominguez, man. He's a good fighter.
Yeah, he's got ability. He's got a decent foundation.
Yeah, sneaky is a good way to describe the shots he's throwing in. Like, you don't really expect him. All of a sudden, oh.
Yeah, he knows how to set him up good. He throws the little pitter-patters up on top, and then he digs hard to the body to try to get him unexpectedly.
It makes sense that Rubio restores classic cars, because I'm looking at his haircut. That's like late 70s, maybe early 80s. I wanted to ask you, JoJo, is it too much hair? If your hair gets that long, does it impair your vision? Does it get in the way? And does it also create an effect for the judges? Like if you get grazed by the punch and your head moves back, you know, the hair pops up and flies, and maybe the judges think that you got hit harder than you really did?
You know what? I truly believe so. And I had my hair long, but not as long as Rubio. And it was affecting my fight, because whenever I was sparring, I could see the hairs going into my eyes, and I could see actually the hairs through my vision, and it's kind of distracting, because that's all you want to see is your opponent, but then you have that little distraction with the hairs going into your vision. So I think it is a distraction, and as far as the judges, it is, because whenever Dominguez is throwing shots, you see the hair moving all the time, and they don't know if it's a block or if it's landing effectively.
Right, if you land a hard punch, the sweat flies off your hair and your hair goes flying, and it may think that you got clipped in an exchange when you really didn't.
That's right. It's kind of like the David Lemieux with Gennady Golovkin, that fight. When Gennady Golovkin was even throwing shots that David Lemieux was blocking, he had long hair and they were just bouncing around everywhere and everybody thought he was getting hit.
That's the price of fashion.
Yeah, exactly, yep.
Shark is on the hunt, stalking Dominguez, landing left of the body, tapping the kidney area and liver area with his right. Dominguez returns fire. Rubio's able to block, step back, come back with a nice right cross.
How you feel? We're not tired, are we?
We're good.
Keep the tweets coming using hashtag RingTV Live. How about this one, Loaded Gloves? Rubio remind you of a young Margarito?
Yeah, you know, with the hair and with the style a little bit. He doesn't have quite the volume of Margarito, but who does? And not as heavy-handed, but there are a lot of similarities.
Thanks to everybody watching. Steve Razzo in Houston, our man, always checking us out. Ready for Emilio Sanchez. Also, Art, who usually works with Golden Boy, watching us on the app right now.
Dominguez landing some nice shots. Good, you know, left, right, left combination, going to the body still hard. There's still some heaviness. There's still some snap to these shots from Dominguez.
And our former intern, Grant, USC product, Harvard Westlake kid, watching. He's no longer an intern with Golden Boy, but he's still watching. That's dedication. Keep the tweets coming using the hashtag RingTVLive. Blood from the nose of Pablo Rubio. He's scrapping. He's earning every single point tonight as Dominguez, a fighter. You said it. He's live. He throws those sneaky ones. Not going to put combos together. He's not going to hurt you, but there's something about a guy who just doesn't go away, isn't it? Frustrating.
Yeah, it is frustrating. That's why with Rubio, he is throwing a lot of shots and being aggressive, but I feel like he has to set up the shots a little more to catch Dominguez unexpectedly, and that's what stops and knocks out opponents.
Right by Rubio.
Yeah, right cross, right to the ear. It looked like it momentarily stunned Dominguez, but he's recovered.
It did. But
he's conning Rubio. Maybe he's dazed, but he's standing there, and he's like, come on, bring it. And Rubio sort of thinks twice.
Yeah, he's conning him with blood coming out of the mouth.
Dominguez never shows that he's hurt, man.
He doesn't show any emotion at all.
None at all.
He's a Juarez cop.
Well, yeah, you can't.
Be tough, man. You can't be soft in that occupation.
Yeah, he's actually coming to fight. It's a little bit easier, a little bit of a break.
But imagine.
Jeez. Less than a minute to go in the sixth round. Good opening bout. Emilio Sanchez is next. After that is Tino Avila and Jose Ramirez. We'll be back here at the Belasco Theater December 2nd when Abe Lopez will be the main event. November 18th, we go to Indio, California. Mauricio Herrera, Pablo Cesar Cano.
Good fight.
Main event, a good one. Eliminator for that one. Rubio's learning that you can throw some power shots, but these men are not going to go anywhere, are they, JoJo?
No, they're not, man. This guy has a great chin, good condition as well. Still a live dog, throwing back and retaliating and making sure that he's still in this fight.
That's one of those, like, you walk away, you're like, damn, I did everything right. What? Like, what? But you learn. You're 19.
It's all learning experience.
It's experience that will help you as you continue to improve in your career and move up the ladder. That'll do it. Six good rounds between Pablo Rubio and Francisco Dominguez. Respect between the two fighters, as Dominguez does, as you taught me, each of those backbones of boxing.
Got to have these guys. You can't have young up-and-comers without sturdy stepping stones, guys who are going to make them use their ability and sort of rise to the occasion in the ring. This is how young fighters take it to the next level. And there's different levels of journeymen, and you get to these journeymen that they're good enough that they're spoilers, and then you get these spoilers that win enough that they're gatekeepers. And every now and then the gatekeepers break into sort of contender status. But the gatekeepers and the journeymen and the spoilers, the stepping stones, you can't have prospects and contenders and eventual world champions without them.
And let's see, Thalia, who did you have winning this fight? Oh, not Thalia. Then who? Doug, who did you have winning this fight?
Oh, yeah, easy to score. I had it a shutout for Rubio. I thought that Dominguez was game. There were some competitive rounds, but I thought Rubio soundly outworked the older fighter in every round.
JoJo?
Same as Doug. I have it a shutout. Rubio was very aggressive, dictating the whole pace of the fight. And I have it a shutout win for Rubio.
And Abe, who did you have winning the fight? Or as Abe is getting fixed right now. Abe, you hear me? Abe doesn't hear me. Okay. I'm pretty sure. Let me just go with from what Abe said earlier in the fight. I think he agrees with you guys. As they're putting Abe's jacket on. Okay. Highlights.
I have it a six-round shutout, but that doesn't mean it wasn't a good fight. As we'll see with these exchanges. Most of this fight was contested in close, in the trenches. In some of the rounds, Dominguez had his moments. And I tell you what, Rubio will know that he had been in a fight tomorrow. Right side of his rib cage is going to be sore. And there was some blood in the nostrils at the end of the fight. And we've gotten used to seeing Rubio bleed a little bit for his victories.
Yeah, but the nostrils, that's usually a punch, right?
Yes, that was definitely from the punch.
And there was a clash earlier, nothing rare, but 19 years old, Paulo Rubio didn't have the highly decorated amateur background.
A lot of a regional standout, not a national class.
Well, especially now in this day and age where guys are saying, forget it, we're not going to go to the Olympics, because now the amateur system going to the Olympics where they get rid of the headgear. If you're 18, let them turn pro.
Yeah, why not get a head start in the professional ranks?
Why risk anything? And there you
see, if you're going to risk cuts and facial lacerations, get paid. That's right.
Get taxed.
Get more exposure.
As Rubio is co-managed by Meta World Peace, who was here earlier on his way to the Lakers-Warriors game. There you see Pablo Sr. with the beard. He puts his hand around his dad. Pretty cool moment for Shark Sports as we're waiting for our ring announcer, Joe Martinez. As they're making sure the cards are right.
Noticing a lot of fighters in attendance. I'm seeing Ronnie Rios and his brother Alexis.
Yeah, they're going to be fighting together. At Ronnie Rios and Alexis, they're going to be fighting in December. And coming up next, Emilio Sanchez, whose younger brother Sal won the night in Ontario. There you see him going, red and black. Okay, I like that color scheme. How do you pick your colors, JoJo?
I just pick them by guessing and just...
By guessing,
just like wondering, what's going to look good on me this fight?
Because you've got neon, you've got camouflage.
Yeah, but my last fight I had to go with the Dallas Cowboys colors because I was in Dallas, Texas.
AT&T Stadium.
Yeah.
How'd that work out for you?
It worked out pretty good. I got good feedback on it. So my next fight I'll probably come out with the Lakers colors.
You going purple and gold at the Forum?
Purple and gold or some yellow and purple.
Well, if you go purple, that's... Doug Fisher, you gotta go Prince, Purple Rain.
Los de los jueces. And now, fine fans, we go to the judges' scorecards. Carla Caiz anotó 59-55. Caiz has it 59-55. Y los jueces, Pat Russell y Fernando Villarreal, anotaron el mismo 60-54, 60-54. For Russell and Villarreal, for your winner by unanimous decision, se mantiene invicto de Whittier, California, Pablo the Shark Rubio Jr.
He is now 8-0, goes the distance, hard-earned victory over Panchito Dominguez. The officer from Ciudad Juarez falls to 7-9, but he did his job. He came and gave him six good rounds.
And Rubio relatively unscathed after these six rounds. He's definitely learning. His conditioning is getting better. His technique is getting better. But
like you said, JoJo, I do think he needs to learn to operate from middle distance and from long range a little bit. Just mix that in there.
Yeah, it's really
to help conserve energy and also just to help limit damage.
Yeah, I mean, it'll make the fight a lot easier if he just, uses his range, fight on the outside, and then, he could be a little more aggressive whenever he feels like it's the right time. But like you said, too, I truly believe that he has to, start working on establishing the jab and working on the outside a little more because he is long and rangy.
But in the meantime, he's a fun fighter to watch because he is the proverbial grinder. Likes to put on pressure, likes to set the pace, likes to punch in volume. And we're seeing him go to work and lump up the face of the 30-year-old man.
I don't know where it goes. Or light fell, that's not where it goes. Light fell, so I don't know.
So here comes Pablo. I'm gonna sit down and talk to him.
We get up or?
Yeah, who's getting up here? As we're waiting for Pablo Rubio Jr. to join us here ringside, Bethel Duran, Doug Fisher, and still undefeated Pablo Rubio Jr.
How
the
you
Shark.
Doing? How you doing?
Congratulations.
How do you feel right now?
I feel great. You know, we were working with Rudy Hernandez, and he pushed me to the limit. And, you know, we did what we had to do. He showed me better movement, better way to throw my punches. And that's what we came here to do. And, you know, the opponent was a tough fighter, and he made it through all the six rounds. We were trying to stop him, but he was good enough to go through.
You've got that old school haircut, and Rudy Hernandez is an old school trainer. He was a former fighter, obviously.
Yep.
His brother, he trained him to two world titles. The late, yep, great Genaro Hernandez also trained Carlos Cuadras for the Chocolatito Showdown.
Yes, and he did amazing.
So he's a taskmaster in there. He was pushing you. And show us what you're, tell us what you're doing here and how the work you did to the gym translates to the ring.
Well, Rudy, you know, he said every time you throw, you have to keep the other hand up, and he told me to plant my feet better, and every time we move to the side, keep the other hand up and go straight to the body, and I felt it a lot where, you know, every time I hit him to the body, I feel like he was like, ugh, like he felt it, and I tried to keep going, but, you know, he was a strong fighter, and he kept doing what he
had to do. He got body shots in there occasionally. Did he ever hurt you to the body with those lefts?
I felt it, but he didn't hurt me because every time we were doing it, every time we were practicing, Rudy said they might catch you as well, but your body's already going to be in a tight position where it wouldn't really hurt. And
it didn't, huh?
And it didn't. We kept going. We tried to keep going.
Your last one here, Meta World Peace was here for you. Before, on his way to the Laker game, he shows up.
Yes.
How was that?
It was cool, man. You know, see, he cares about his fighters as a manager. And he came out here right before his game, wished me luck. And, you know, I wish the best for him, too, today, tonight. And hopefully we're probably going to go out and go see him. You know?
8-0. He's now 8-0, 19-year-old Pablo Rubio Jr. from Whittier, California. We'll be back with more. Emilio Sanchez is next on Ring TV Live.
Thank you.